Hello. In this video, after a YouTube comment question, someone wanted to add an additional on-off for the automation. So here's what I come up with. Here we can see the IKEA Air Quality Sensor for the office here with its automation. And over on my GitHub page, I've added a new YAML file. And this contains what you need to add to this code. So first of all, we've got a switch. This uses the substitution and it's called master. Still uses the substitution here, which is the name. I'm going to copy that from the GitHub page. Let's copy that into there. I'm going to put this above sensor just to make it nice and easy for you to see. Add three lines, come up one, paste that in. That will give me an additional switch. And then in the sensor, you've got the whole code here, but all you really need is this extra condition here. So it uses the and. So whereas before we had just a binary sensor on off, and if you remember the binary sensor for me, I'm just using the acquire door and window sensor, which is sitting on the window. Back down to the sensor and the automation. I've given you the whole code here so you know where to put it. But basically, we're going to copy these three lines here because we need the and. Copy that, and I'm going to replace those two lines, like so. So what that'll do, that'll give us an additional switch, which will show up in Home Assistant here. And that additional switch, when it's enabled, it will allow this automation to run as normal. And when you turn the switch off, it will ignore that and just go to the else. So if we install that now, once that installs and reconnects to Home Assistant, you'll see an additional switch turn up here. So now we do a time lapse. So there you go, it's going to update the code. This will go offline. And then when it comes back online, we should see a new control turn up, which is our switch. So there you go, we've got the Office IKEA AQ, which is the substitution name, followed by master, which is what I've added here. So that's the on-off for the automation in this code. So let's look at it in action. So here we have both units side by side. We've got the air quality sensor and we've got the air purifier, both of which are in the office. Now, my office one is only a 4-speed device, but it still works the same. So at the moment, we can see the particle count is 282 and the current air purifier fan speed is speed 3. Now, if I turn it off, next time this gets updated, you can see this has now gone off. So this essentially is disabling the output of the IKEA sensor in the office. So it's not sending data to the fan anymore, and therefore it goes off. So if I turn it back on, next time this sensor gets updated, which was just then because the fan's running, we can see now that's gone up to speed 3. So there you go, a quick update, which gives you extra control, which you can apply to an automation. So say, for instance, at night, you don't want the air filter to run. You can have an automation in Home Assistant just to toggle that switch on and off. And like I say, this comes into Home Assistant as a switch. Well, I hope this video was helpful for your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I love you. Bye-bye.